10 News can reveal tonight an alarming increase in the number of payouts to victims of police brutality. The compensation bill is running into the millions, and there are now calls for the government to crack down on excessive violence by police.
This incident sparked a continuing police investigation into whether the officer was using excessive violence or following legitimate arrest tactics. There's no suggestion it's a case of brutality, but police actions are increasingly being investigated. Here, officers tramp on a man's abdomen and knee him in the groin. A magistrate dismissed charges that the victim had assaulted police. In the past year, 17 other people have won compensation for assault by police. 34 cases have been concluded for assault, false imprisonment and malicious prosecution, with payouts totalling $5.3 million. Critics say it's the tip of the iceberg.
This is a deeply disturbing trend. Not only are the numbers of cases increasing, but the amount taxpayers are forking out is increasing.
Paddy Gibson was arrested during protests at APEC and won an undisclosed payout from New South Wales Police.
I was in severe physical discomfort. It was very, very scary. You're these huge police officers, you know, I'm being pushed into the concrete, which caused a, you know, very large amount of pain.
I've had clients report to me that they've been severely beaten after they've been arrested. And police officers aren't SS officers. They're law enforcement officers and they should be squeaky clean. That's what the public expects.
Lawyers say the police force fights hard to beat those claiming compensation in the courts, but as it faces an increasing number of complaints, the police force says it's now moving to resolve these disputes using mediation. Police Minister Mike Gallagher would not be interviewed, saying complaints were thoroughly investigated. Commissioner Andrew Scipione was also too busy to comment. John Hill, 10 News.